In this question, we have two ships at noon. At noon means that at 12 o'clock. Okay, at noon. Okay, at 12:00 at noon. Ship A is 100 kilometers due east, ship B. And we can remember the directions. And this is north. This is south. This is west. This is east. We are given that ship A is 100 kilometers due east of ship B. If I say ship B somewhere here, ship A will be 100 kilometers apart from ship B to the east. Okay, this is the ship position of ship B, and ship A is at this location, which is 100 kilometers apart from ship B. This is the starting position at noon. Okay, at 12 o'clock, this is the position of two ships. Ship A sailing west. Okay, this is the direction of the ship A. Okay, west, from east to west, and 12 kilometers per hour. Okay, 12 kilometers per hour. This is the speed of the ship A, and ship B is sailing south. Okay, this is the direction of ship B. Okay, it is moving like this to the south, and the speed of the ship is 10 kilometer per hour. Okay, let me write. It is 10 kilometer per hour in this direction. The question says, at what time will the ships be nearest to each other, and what will this distance be? At what time? Suppose that after T hours, let ship A be here. Okay, after T hours. And then let ship B somewhere here after T hours. Okay? After T hours, the distance between two ships will be seen in this way. Okay? This is the distance between them after T hours. Let us say this is S. Okay? This is S. So the question says S is minimum. Okay? S is minimum for after how many hours? What time? Okay, what time of the day they have the closest distance between them. So I have to write the S as a function of time, okay, and then differentiate. So how can I write the distance taken by B? Okay, we know that the distance, okay, S, or let us say change in the distance, is equal to V times T, right? Constant velocity time. And velocity of the B is 10, and the distance taken by B will be 10 times T kilometer. Okay? And the distance, the ship B will cover 10 T kilometer in T hours with the velocity 10 kilometer per hour. Similarly, this is the distance covered by ship A. So ship A has the speed 12. In T hours, ship A will cover 12 T kilometer. Okay, the distance taken by ship A. So at the beginning, the distance between A and B was 100 kilometers. So I can find the difference of the distances. I can find the remaining distance to the starting position of B. It was 100 kilometers at the beginning. I am subtracting the distance taken by A, which is it is getting closer and closer to the starting point of B, but B is not here, B is somewhere else. But we can say that it is 100 minus 12 t kilometer. This length is 100 minus 12 t kilometer. So I got my triangle sides as one of them is 100 minus 12 t, the other one is 10 t. So by using Pythagorean theorem, I can write the equation for the distance between A and B after t hours. So S square is equal to 100 minus 12 t squared plus 10 t squared. This is Pythagorean theorem, 10 t squared. So instead of expanding parentheses, just take the derivative directly. Okay, it will be easier in that way. Derivative of s squared is 2s s prime. Okay. And derivative of this parenthesis, power rule and chain rule, 2 100 minus 12t times derivative of the inside 100 minus 12 times 1, negative 12. That's it. Plus, again, this is, you can apply the chain rule again, and it is 2, 10t, derivative of the inside is 10. That's it. Arrange this one, it is negative 24, okay, because we must multiply 2 and 2 and negative 12 first. Negative 2400 minus 12t plus, again, 10 times 10 times 10. It is 200t. And then expand the bracket by negative 24. Negative 200, 2400 plus 24 times 12. 24 times 12, let us check. 288. It is 288t plus 200t. And then finally, negative 2400, 488t. So this s prime is zero when this expression is zero. Okay, because this is 2s s prime, right? This s prime is zero. Okay, is zero when this side is zero, because 2x cannot be zero, it is length. So I'm writing this expression equal to zero. Minus 2400 plus 488t must be zero. 488t is equal to 2400, and t is equal to 2400 divided by 488. And this is approximately equal to what? Let us see by calculator. 2400 divided by 488. Answer is 4.9. We can get this one close to 5, okay? Approximately 5 hours. After approximately 5 hours, they will be close to each other. What time of the day? It was 12 a.m. Okay, after 5 hours, it will be 5:00 p.m. Okay, after 5 hours, they will be nearest. And what is the distance? Okay, what is the distance between them? I can find the distance by replacing 5 in the distance function. Okay, s square is equal to 100 minus 12 times 5 squared. It is 10 times 5 squared. Okay, s square is equal to, this is 60, 40, okay, 100 minus 60, it is 40 squared plus 50 squared. So take the square of 40 and 50, 4 times 4, 1600, 5 times 5, 2500, and then s square is equal to 35, 41, 4100, and s is equal to root of 4100. Okay, we can write the answer in this way. Okay, we can get the 100 outside, 10 times root of 41, but let us find the approximate result for this one. Square root of 4100. Okay, I'm using calculator. 4100 square root. See that it is approximately 64 kilometers. We can say that they will be 64 kilometers apart from each other, and this is the closest point they can get with respect to each other, and they will be closest to each other at 5 p.m. That's it.